I'm here, Marie, and I'm actually here with Tim Dunn as well, the Launch Services Program. Tim, can you tell us about how today's launch went?
Hey, Josh. Wow. Are we excited? I mean, we just had a perfect countdown and perfect launch of the TESS mission. It was a wonderful day. Obviously, if you got any views outside here off the Central Coast, you saw what a gorgeous day it was. So we had perfect weather for the launch. We had a terrific rocket. The Falcon 9 just continues to demonstrate what a reliable ride it has become. And spacecraft, we turned on TESS spacecraft early this morning, and that went super smooth. We worked one very minor little item with TESS during the countdown. Was really insignificant in the overall picture. TESS was really solid during the rest of the countdown, and the range, hats off to the United States Air Force and the 45th Space Wing. They continue to have a beautiful range for us to launch on. And again, I don't have a whole lot to talk about as far as troubles during the countdown. It was super smooth, beautiful day, a beautiful launch, a great rocket, and we now have an operational spacecraft on its way to do great science.
And talking about the importance of the TESS mission, can you talk about from the perspective of the Launch Services Program, how it is to launch TESS?
Oh, wow. Well, for us, this was only Launch Services Program's second flight on a Falcon 9 rocket. A couple of years ago, we did the Jason 3 mission from the West Coast. And so this was our second full-up science mission on Falcon 9. So our entire team of engineers and analysts within LSP was able to demonstrate another certification process where we certified this full thrust version, Block 4, that flew today. And to see all of that hard work for the past 2.5 years that the entire Falcon 9 team within LSP put together, to see that rewarded with a successful launch means so much to our team. And it's an incredible team. And SpaceX has an incredible team. Their engineers and analysts here at the launch site here at Cape Canaveral, as well as their team back in California at Hawthorne. My hat's off to them. Terrific launch team. And when you put us all together, the government and the commercial guys together, it's just so satisfying to watch a team kind of seamlessly blend and integrate to accomplish such an important mission for our agency.
So it sounds like a pretty exciting night for both SpaceX and NASA. And the Launch Services Program has a big year, and we've got big stuff coming up still. Can you tell us about what's next for the Launch Services Program?
Absolutely. So we were thrilled to launch tonight, mainly because now it kind of clears a little bit of the runway, because our Atlas V team now has to turn around, get out to the West Coast for the InSight mission, flying in just 2.5 weeks on May 5th from Vandenberg Air Force Base. And then we have a Pegasus mission coming up with the Icon spacecraft, and that's going to stage out of Vandenberg, fly downrange to Quadge, and launch from Quadge in mid-June. Right now we're targeting June 14th. We come back here to the Cape in the end of July. We'll be processing the Parker Solar Probe mission, which is a mission to go study the sun. And it will be the first time LSP has flown a science mission on the Delta IV Heavy. So that's very exciting for our team. And then if all goes according to plan, our sixth and final mission for LSP for 2018 will occur in September from Vandenberg Air Force Base again. And that will be the ISAT-2 mission on the very last Delta II launch vehicle. So I would say if you're a Delta II fan out there, you might want to find your way to the Central California coast right around September 12th, because that's going to be a very special event to watch the final Delta II fly. It's been a workhorse for the agency, and it's really special to a lot of folks that have been in this business for the last 30 years now that it's been flying.
Well, it sounds like we've got a lot to look forward to from the Launch Services Program, and then a lot to look forward to with the TESS mission, which we launched successfully tonight. So with that, we'll sign off and go back to you, Marie. Thank you.
All right.